knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, the challenger, Killer Kylie Fulmer. Introducing her opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. She enters the ring wearing black trunks with red trim, officially weighing in at 53.4 kilograms. Hailing from Hamilton, Brisbane, Queensland. Ladies and gentlemen, she's trained by Glenn Azar out of the Project 180 in Brisbane, with a fight record of 4 fights, 3 wins, just 1 loss, 1 win by knockout. She is the reigning, defending Australian female bantamweight champion. Please make some noise for the matador, Taylah Robertson. Fighters to the center of the ring, please. Final instructions from your referee, Paul Tapley.
Okay, ladies, I spoke to you both from the dressing rooms. Obey my commands at all times, protect yourselves at all times. Touch gloves, good luck to the both of you.
Fantastic reception for Taylah Robertson in particular. Also plenty there to support Kylie Fulmer. Interesting bout to kick us off. The Australian female bantamweight title being defended by Robertson.
Zone. She knows where her distance is. She knows just to move up and bring her opponent on the plate. It's very, very skilled. She'll get better and better.
Both girls are showing a lot of skill, but I think that, like I said, Fulmer, when she throws punches, she's got to get in close. Every time she comes back out, she gets hit very, very quickly by the super quick Taylah Robertson.
So get our jab back on, fade right hand, then go down to the body. So think about that second phase. First phase is beautiful.
Yeah.
Controlled, big breaths, don't rush anything. Expect her to come out a bit hard at the start of the round, yeah? Be ready for that rush.
Second phase is key.
Okay, you look like a champion. That's how you need to be.
Yeah.
Stand up.
Right first round.
Big strong breath. Feel good.
That is trainer Glenn Azar in the corner of Taylah Robertson.
Champion.
Box. Resumes the battle here against Kylie Fulmer, who gets straight on the jab. the hook around. Robertson comes back with three.
I can see that right here. He's going to end more and more from Robertson. His former, his jab is moving into it. The right hand
moving. Can I have it, John? Can I have it? No, hit it on the back of the head.
She needs it to jab and stay straight. And look down to the right hand.
Don't just go fucking one off, because she's fucking picking you off.
Gotcha, okay.
You understand?
Yeah. Let him go.
Let him go?
Yeah.
Don't do single shots, she's picking you off.
Alright.
Otherwise everything else is fine.
Yeah.
Defense nice and high.
Yeah.
You understand?
Be aware of what way you're moving into that right hand.
Okay.
Be aware of what way you're moving.
Right.
Don't go into that right hand. Okay.
Punching bunches. 1-2 hook, 1-2-3.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter, fucking punching bunches.
Yeah.
Grab the chair.
Drive the tyres, Dad. Tapu off the tyre in the corner.
Box.
Definitely.
Both teams just poker. Both teams poker punching in bunches in that one. Being straight, that goes into the right hand. So she's got some good advice. Let's see. Good
stuff in the corner.
Taylor Robertson, and I know she needs the punching
punch. The body there that's right. And again, and she's growing in confidence. Just dips down.
No push.
And again, and quick hands get on. She's trying to finish it off, but
let your heads go.
In that last 20 seconds. Big breath. How do you feel? How's she looking?
Tired.
Right. long right hand to the body. We haven't really thrown that much yet. So let's back off in the first part of the round because we want to set stuff up in the second part. Get your jab back on. If you're a little bit lazy there, long right to the body, some single shots. And then the second half of the round, we go back and do what you just did. We start to push your fatigue in the second half of the round.
Get that body work up, hey? She doesn't like it.
This is round four coming up, right?
Yeah.
So halfway through, you're feeling good. You've got the tank for this. You've got the skills.
Yeah, definitely.
Get your jab work. Your jab's a power.
Very, very skillful. It was great to see that kind of thing. Try and listen to what her coach has said, which is really, really important.
What would they have said, do you think, between those?
There have been a few more in the four-letter words, and they told us that she's doing a little bit more. That's it, good, a little bit more. Good punch, good punch. Up and down. That was good.
Good work to the body.
And it was. It brought the hands down to finish over the top. Great work.
Work out of it. Work out of it, girls. Break! Step back, step back. Tighten it up.
The thing to me, Ben, is that Fulmer's looking a little fatigued, where Robertson, roll camera out.
Now hold it, girls, break out of it.
She's got great hands, she's got great distance, she's got a great eye as well. She bent down, she's standing with a gap up the middle, but she doesn't get she throws the right uppercut. Oh, what a high score there, huh?
He rises again, but the action is gone. And the top gets through with two more shots. Good action with some of these girls. Number four, or eight. Fulmer again. She's working hard in this fourth round. She's trying to get away from it. That's a big shot. Takes her his advice in the corner.
Listen,
he was on the money again.
He's saying goodbye to you. He's listening to you, Ben. He's got you wired up.
And he said, let's go on those right hands with that hook.
But Ben, let me tell you something. That thing is your passion, nothing real. And as you try the right hand, it's pretty much a very short.
Right, step back,
enjoying this, she's
taking a rest. Definitely trying, but she's doing one thing wrong. She's throwing the punches without moving the feet. The feet are stationary and she throws punches. And then remember, your opponent's moving back, they're seeing the punches. So Taylor's got to see where she moves back and throws the punches. And our
right, step back, forward. Step back.
Can as well, and she tries to throw a big overhand, which is quite a lot.
How do you feel? Big breath. Calm down. Alright, the pressure's starting to get to her. We're still feeling good, okay? Same as we've been doing. Start easy in the first time. Then she respects it, then we do the other work. Uppercuts inside are beautiful. You're biting down when you need to, you're getting a bit of mongrel about you. When you hurt her, jump low, you're not going silly. That was beautiful. That was a good round. The ups and downs are nice. Let's keep all of that. How's she looking?
Jab going, okay?
Big breath. All right, round six. Okay, you can do this for 8 rounds if you have to. She wants to take it.
That's because she puts herself in a really great position before she throws it. She knows where she puts her head before she throws it up at that one. Really, really good.
Six between Robertson and
Fulmer. Yeah, well, like I said, the fourth round is actually a very, very close round, but I still gave it to Robertson. And I think the other round, the fifth round, was maybe the best round she's had in the final.
Work out of it, girls, work out of it. Girls, work out of it.
And the crazy thing is, Bout training a girl, I believe, at the moment. And Kate with Pat McCollum, and then, yeah, hope she's watching at home. And yeah, this is a very, very good lesson for all the people out here for women to watch. Great fight.
As you get on to
she's got to continue to punch. When she stops punching, she's got to make angles. Don't stand in front of her. Get to the side.
Yeah, you've got to work.
Team Fennec,
you're more effective when you're first. Bill, don't let the punches start getting your shots off.
Otherwise,
everything else is good.
Well, I've got Hats Hampton as well, but I've got the great Johnny Stephenson who jumped on board and he's really working hard. He's changed his diet.
Step back, girls. Step back.
Angle again and minute of the second round of eight here. Fulmer still working hard. Regularly.
Yeah, she's definitely has a beautiful match.
Step back. Work out of it.
Straight hand. She threw that straight one, then she threw her hands up and she put one around the glove as well. She got a great eye. She's got a great eye.
End of round seven.
Only one to go,
eh?
Ringside
for an
action, Jeff.
Last round, Kylie touch gloves.
She's doing a very, very good job, Taylah Robertson. It's so good to have Jeff Horn as a
last
part
round,
of
touch
our
gloves.
Coverage this evening.
Last round.
We get closer to our co-main. Risking it all tonight.
Touch gloves, girls.
Right now, 2 more minutes of this. What a fight it's been between Taylah Robertson and Kylie Fulmer. Robertson well and truly ahead and tries to retain her Bantamweight Australian title, but she's trying to finish it off this
stage. Yeah, she's taking risks as well, though. She has an eagle, she's 7 rounds, she's zipping by his own control. She's been moving around, just yeah, picking her punches and doing what she wants, but here she is, she's ready for battle.
No hold, Kylie, no hold.
Particular, she is trying to give them something to remember tonight. Taylah Robertson is entertaining her fans and they take their hands, a pair of them, and she's got a cheeky left hand on the inside.
I'll tell you what, she's doing the roots up there. This is a very skilled young lady. Beautiful job, step back to her.
Work out of it, girls.
Let's go, Brisbane title fight after grabs. Make some noise.
Work out of it. Get your heads free. Watch your heads in there.
Shots from both.
Feel, but be proud of that.
Disappointed with herself.
Well, she's got nothing to be disappointed that she opponent who was there for the whole 8 rounds, right in front of her, and she done a great job.
How do you think she can go?
Taylah
Robertson,
basically. Watching that, I think that she's got as much skill as any late fighter I've seen here or overseas. That was pretty impressive.
That was a showcase for women on track.
Here's the highlights.
And then just watching that trade out there, the punch out, she was throwing punches from the side of the shoulder instead of in front of the chin. And just something that she'll learn, hopefully she'll listen to what she's doing. Now she'll close that up as well.
Good fight. Well done.
Okay, let's count these scores. Here it is, Dave.
Ladies and gentlemen, our opening bout of the night, proudly brought to you by CrossBet. After 8 rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge Alan Burford scored about 80-72 to Robertson. Judge Paul Williams scored about 80-72 to Robertson. Judge Philip Holliday scored about 80-72 for a unanimous decision. It's still the Australian Peter Bantamweight champion, the Matador, Taylah Robertson.